the king.
Pimp C, why are you so mad? It just seemed like you real angry.
You know why I'm mad? Let me tell you why I'm mad. I'm mad because everybody on these records lying. Everybody lying. Everybody's this big D-boy. Everybody's these hardcore gangsters. Everybody gonna do this to each other when they see each other. And the truth be told, we too blessed and we having too much money in this rap game to be going to war with each other.
Right. Okay.
And the truth be told, don't nobody want to fight nobody in this rap game. The 98% of these dudes is cowards.
What's up, man?
Nigga, fuck bracket. Yeah. Big B shit.
You a bitch, nigga. Fuck you talking about. I beat your ass. Bitch ass, nigga. Fuck you talking about. Boy, I got my shit on me, bitch. Bitch ass, nigga. Look at you running. Look at this bitch ass nigga running. Bitch,
you saying that, what do you think needs to be done?
This is what I think needs to be done, man. Come on, man. At the end of these records we listen to, we don't get nothing out of them no more, man. We don't get no social commentary. We ain't getting no kind of knowledge out these records. Everybody just talking about how many chains they got on and how much dope they sold. But the truth of the matter is this, I don't believe you. Because I know you do, and I know you didn't sell no dope.
Rick Ross finally confesses or owns up to being a correction officer. So our first chance to talk about this, was Rick Ross a CO? Was that created or is that a real picture?
See, this is what we did, right? I got with BET and we doing a whole special on my life. We chronicling my life. You know, I made a few moves, you understand? And I feel like it was the best decisions for me to be here.
If them boys talking about, man, them boys ain't got no fights like that, no Atlanta. And if you do, right now, bring some where my people at, we'll buy it and flush it down the toilet. We don't support drugs.
So basically, you just calling the game real fake, and you saying that the music need to go back to some real lyrics. And
Let me say this. There's a whole bunch of people lying. So if you want to point fingers at somebody, they're pointing fingers at everybody. Am I lying or telling the truth? I'm dissing everybody lying about selling drugs. It ain't touched a nail truth. Because if you're going to talk about some squares and talk about the drug game, you need to talk about the bad side of the drug game too. What about when you get busted and you go to jail? What about when your mama and your wife and your kids is crying because they at home and you in prison in a cell? What about that part of the dope game? Everybody talking about how many cars and how many jewels they going to buy and how many squares coming out. You know what I'm talking about? But ain't nobody talking about the other side of it.
Come on, you goddamn, let me know. Give you 5 minutes to load up.
Are rappers really rich? Well, it sure seems like it. From their fast cars and million-dollar mansions all the way to their designer clothes and fancy jewelry, you name it, they probably flexed it. And there's a good reason for it. Two words, social acceptance. It says their job isn't to entertain us, it's to entertain the executives of their label by deceiving the masses into idolizing the entertainer and thinking they can live the same life as them if they strive to emulate the lifestyle the entertainer claims they live. Another revenue stream is going on tour. You see it everywhere. Your favorite artist is traveling and performing in a city near you. This is where the most of the money is actually made. The average rapper could still end up with just over $600,000 after the tour. To be fair, and that's still not a lot of money compared to what they want you to believe. But yeah, they have $600,000, that's cool. But when you spend almost all of it on jewelry and cars, you aren't rich any longer. You're just a big spender that can't control a budget.
Hey, Pimp.
Yes, sir.
Do you mind expressing any of those rappers you was talking about?
Them sugar sausages?
Oh, man. I want to know.
Them gay rappers you know about?
Nah, man. It's no need to embarrass nobody that ain't done nothing to us.
Yeah. Respect.
But if you gay, man, and you ashamed of it, you need to stop doing stuff you're ashamed of. Anything done in the dark gonna come to the light. I ain't gotta expose them, cause they exposing they self every day and every night.
I do gotta ask you about the leopard print joint you had on. Now was that a shirt or was that a dress?
Oh yeah, that was a dress.
We need to stop promoting negative things.
Yeah.
UGK was started out talking about drugs and things, but now we on the record talking about the other side of the drugs and what happens when you get off into negative things. We need to stop promoting the wrong thing.
That's definitely somebody got to step up and make it happen.
Somebody got to do it. And guess what? You think anybody that did it, they was gonna like it when they heard? Don't nobody like meth. It don't taste good. They just want a whole bunch of the same old everybody licking each other's booty and being cops.
going to. That's what it's going to. Then it's time for a contract to come out. Then when I'm saying 5 years, you like, nah, dog. So you don't want to sign with us. Nah, not for no nah. Man, pop in the tape. Show this nigga what he did last night. Then that motherfucker like, man, what the fuck? Yeah, well, what the fuck? That's what happened. You got fucked. What you gonna do? You gonna sign that contract.
At this hour, members of the hip-hop community are mourning the shocking death of well-known Port Arthur rapper Pimp C. Pimp C, who was born Chad Butler, was one half of the rap group UGK and was found dead this morning in a hotel room in Los Angeles.
I got a question for anybody following you. What kind of nigga take a picture in a Lucky Charm suit with a lollipop chain and some leprechaun boots? Hey, being lame is a curse you can never undo. Even worse, your reputation gon' forever haunt you. If you a suck at 12 and 22, you weren't too. Regardless of your possessions or who you can run to, no matter how many blessings God place upon you, your heart pump serves so niggas can punk you.
I remember one day coming from the studio at 6 o'clock in the morning and pulling over on the highway. We like four cars, you know, just to watch the sunrise. And it was at that point that I fell in love with Arizona. I said, you know what, this has to be God's country. You know, because I'd never seen anything as beautiful as that sunrise. Then I met the devil in God's country. You know, and it's not so much who, it's what, you know, what happens and the things that the devil does. It's not so much a person, even though he acts through people. You know, you can't call one person the devil.
Jeremiah?
You know, you can't call any one person the devil. You can't do that because no one person has enough power to be the devil.
What I'm gonna speak on is the thing that's on my mind the most. You know what I'm saying? The thing that we all gotta deal with every day but don't really know. The industry. Man, it's not the same. Doesn't have to do with talent, it's about playing the game. The industry, real niggas is dying to get in. The industry, just to find they don't fit in.